Okay, so let's imagine that the horizon line is above our sketchbook. So all our perspectives are top-down perspectives. Makes sense, you know, all these quad bikes are smaller than your average person. Okay, and obviously we'll go for more motorcycles later. So a lot of curvy shapes, a lot of vertical ellipses, and we will need to add a bit of detailing, because detailing is going to, you know, add the volumetric sort of information. Drawing is half artistic, architectural drawing is half artistic, half information. If you can see that glare on top of the front mask for the quad bike, extremely important. You need to get that shiny metal finish, and to make those wheels look as volumetric as possible, we're adding all that detailing. We need to make the curves stand out. Okay, we will get to a bit more detailing, and we will add a cast shadow soon, because short mistake, that's going to correct it really fast. Again, a lot of detailing. Obviously this isn't a final drawing that's going to take 3 hours. It's just a short 10-15 minute sketch, which obviously is very, very good for adding context to buildings. Let's say you're drawing a house perspective, like in a mountain area, right? Well, you could add a couple of quad bikes to add a bit of information, a bit of context to your perspective. Okay, a bit of glare again. Boom, let's go for the other quad bike. So again, starting with the wheels, which are vertical ellipses, you can see that the quad bike wheels are rotated. The front wheels are rotated, so the ellipses look different. They're not as open as the other ones, right? The back wheels, you could argue that they look almost like close to a round ellipse, while the other wheels are, in fact, a bit more flat. Okay, a bit of detailing again. You can see the line drawing is very accurate. It follows the curvature of our volumes. We'll never get good drawings if we've got a flat and expressive line drawing. You need to have those curves. Okay, the front light, and again detailing. Detailing makes the world go round. Okay, we will add some glare, some of those glossy finishes. To the wheels as well, but mostly to the metal parts of our volume. Okay, a bit more detailing. Yeah, detailing is essential. Okay, but fast detailing, not again 2 hour long studies. Those are some other exercises for a other time. Right, we'll add the front mask of our quad bike, again a bit more glare, and we will go for a cast shadow really soon. That is going to make everything look more volumetric. Okay, just a short gradient, and boom, next. Let's go for pen this time. So pen is kind of the same as 2B pencil. The only difference is that you can't erase it. So most people would be intimidated by that, but I recommend you sketch in pen or liner, which one you like. Liner is very, it's kind of weird on adding gradients. But pen works very, very well for gradients, and you can't erase it, but that's not a problem. You know, when you've got an error, you don't erase the error, you distract attention from it. Right, so adding the body of our bike, you can see the body is kind of a weird volume. It's not, curvy volume. Sorry, it is a curvy volume, but it's not a elliptic volume, it's not a boxy volume, it's like a composite volume, okay? So we need to keep that in mind for our drawing. Right, detailing in the foreground, as much of the bulky look as we could get. Right, that grid over there adds a bit of a nice rhythm. Again, this would work as a really, really nice foreground for a perspective. You can see this in context, you know, in a city perspective or something, okay? So that would work really well. These are weird entourages, but you sometimes need to draw weird stuff. But again, ellipses, and we're going for another motorbike. You can see the line drawing is kind of messy when we're starting, because the volume itself is kind of hard to understand. It's a bit complicated if you want to construct a volume to understand it when it's not a simple box. Okay, so let's go. Let's add a bit more detailing. we are going to make things look a bit more interesting. You can tell by the way the line is fluctuating, okay? So you can see that's in perspective, okay? You see the front mask of our motorbike is kind of, it gets smaller as the curve goes around in perspective. Yeah, a bit frustrating now because it's kind of complicated to nail these proportions down. You know, you can't obviously sketch something on the first try and boom, it's perfect. You need to have a couple attempts, okay? But we are doing our best to get a very bulky look. Okay, the foreground needs a bit more detailing, right? You can see now that it's starting to take shape. So a bit more contrast. As a tip, try to squint your eyes to see where you need to add more contrast. Contrast is very, very important for drawing. It's going to make everything be clear, easy to read, right? And that's very important. Comes hand in hand with you know, confidence. I've seen students draw very good and in a confident way, and they had good results. But I've seen students draw in, you know, just a decent way, but they were still confident and they still had good results. Very important stuff. The car shadow, yeah, number two there. Yeah, just sketching a bit more detailing. This could work very well in a perspective. Boom, next. Right, let's see another bike. So again, we are talking about ellipses. I should have taken a bit more, to be honest, time to construct these ellipses. I've almost guesstimated them. They are like 80% there. But you could always tell the difference when you construct something. You know, it's 100% there. It's where it needs to be. Once we got a pilot now on our bike, okay. So we got like a human silhouette. If you remember, and I will post a lesson on drawing people for Entourage again. People are notoriously hard to sort out because we will get used to drawing boxes and the buildings and stuff. That's mainly, you know, architectural. Drawing people isn't that intellectual, let's say, but still it requires a level of mastery over your drawing. Okay, we've got a car shadow, and now we need to thicken these lines and add a bit more detailing. Well, fast drawing. Okay, let's see. So this is almost a frontal view. Okay, you can see the weird volume. Weird volumes are good, because obviously they challenge you. You can use this approach after sketching a couple of motorbikes. You can use this approach to come up with a interesting idea for your work. Something that's not necessarily a box. A deconstructivist approach would work. Again, keep in mind, form follows function. You can't just come up with forms and expect them to work. But again, it's good to deviate, it's good to, you know, not get used to the same old approach. Yeah, this bike has got a fixture there, so it's not like it's floating midair. Right, okay, a bit more detailing again. Yeah, line weights, very important to get clarity. And we're getting close to the end of this sketch. Again, a very, very fast sketch. Car shadow there. Okay, so let's see, one more bike. This is going to be, what do you call these, because I forgot. A Vespa, right? This is a Vespa, like in a type of Italian bike, which is kind of like close to a scooter, right? So, it's very interesting. It's got different curves. Again, it could be a very, very good foreground or detailing in a street level perspective, just to create a bit more atmosphere. Because you imagine these, they're not as fast as the other motorbikes, so they can work as you know, you've got an urban perspective and you've got a street where you only have pedestrian access, and you could add one of these Vespas there. Okay, careful with keeping the glossy look going, and with the mirrors. Right, a bit more detailing. We are going to go for cast shadows. Always add cast shadows, because that's going to make everything stick together. Right, architectural drawing sticks together. It's not something that's basically flat and floating midair, but something that's strongly anchored to the ground. Okay, that's why it's got a cast shutter. Right, a bit more detailing again. Really fast. 10-minute sketch. Boom. We are there. Okay. Yeah, line drawing again plays in the essential role. You can see if you squint your eyes that the line goes from darker to lighter. Okay, the contour line needs to be thicker now. Right. Okay. No, we'll skip that one. It's a short sketch. Well, we're going to go for like a more futuristic image now. Right, for a bike. Okay. So again, two ellipses and they're connected. And we are going to imagine how we can fit the body of our motorbike between those two wheels, those massive wheels. Again, we're trying to make these wheels hollow on the inside. It's very important to understand body metrics and not just glue on all sorts of stuff, right? Our volumes need to be like, they go in, they taper in, they go out, they extrude, they subtract, right? So that's the handlebar. Again, a bit more detailing. It's a short glare over there. Right, so you can probably tell that this type of sketching, just do this every day for like 30 minutes. You probably start by doing one bike for 30 minutes, but that's fine. It is going to add a lot of fluency in your line drawing. Okay, so getting close to the end with this sketch as well. We got the car shadow, we got a bit more detailing. Those lines go in perspective. Okay, we need to add a bit more detailing and some contour lines as well. And that's going to be kind of the wrap for this sketch. Right, let's see. Yeah, so the last sketch is going to be a aerial view of a bike. So it's like those crazy, you know, bike stunts, right? Where you see a bike like flying midair, right? Just before it lands, you see this sort of image. So we got again two vertical ellipses, right, with all the wheel detailing, right? And we need to connect those wheels to the bike. Oh snap, no, my mistake. I'm doing the top down again. Come on, man, I thought I had one bottom up. Oh well. So again, it's a back view, sorry. So my mistake, sorry, it's a back view of a bike, right? Again, detailing, sketching, really fast, just with a pen. I can say that a pen gives you more clarity. It's going to sharpen your line drawing. After we're done with sharpening the line drawing, we can, again, go for more and more detailing, right? That detailing is meant to make the roundness of these wheels pop out. And we're getting closer to the end of this sketch, okay? Cast shadows and boom, we're done.